General risk disclosure. Trading financial instruments, including forex, futures, equities, commodities, and cryptocurrencies, involves significant risk of loss. Trading is not suitable for all investors, as it may result in the loss of your entire investment. Leverage, volatility, and liquidity risks are inherent in these markets. Before engaging in trading, carefully consider your financial situation, experience level, and risk tolerance. You should only invest money you can afford to lose. Forex and futures disclaimer. Trading in the forex and futures markets is highly speculative and carries a substantial risk of loss. The leveraged nature of these instruments amplifies gains and losses, potentially leading to substantial financial exposure. This content complies with CFTC Rule 4.41. CFTC Rule 4.41 Disclaimer. Hypothetical or simulated performance results have certain inherent limitations. Unlike an actual performance record, simulated results do not represent actual trading. Also, since the trades have not been executed, the results may have under- or overcompensated for the impact, if any, of certain market factors, such as lack of liquidity. Simulated trading programs are also subject to the fact that they are designed with the benefit of hindsight. No representation is being made that any account will or is likely to achieve profits or losses similar to those shown. Equities and commodities disclaimer. Equity and commodity trading involves risks associated with market volatility, company-specific factors, and geopolitical events. While stocks and commodities may have a lower leverage factor compared to forex or futures, they can still result in substantial financial losses. Cryptocurrency disclaimer. Cryptocurrencies are speculative and highly volatile instruments. Trading cryptocurrencies involves additional risks, including regulatory uncertainties, security vulnerabilities, and lack of liquidity. Cryptocurrencies are not regulated by most governments or central banks, and their value may be affected by external factors such as news events and market sentiment. Regulatory references. In the United States, this content adheres to the regulatory standards of the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, National Futures Association, and Securities and Exchange Commission. In the European Union, trading practices comply with the European Securities and Markets Authority standards. Global compliance, content aligns with internationally accepted guidelines, but laws vary by jurisdiction. Consult with a licensed professional in your area. Past performance disclaimer. Past performance is not indicative of future results. Any historical results or performance shown in this content are for informational purposes only and do not guarantee future performance. Educational content disclaimer. The information provided in this video is for educational and informational purposes only. It is not intended as investment advice, nor should it be construed as a recommendation to buy, sell, or hold any financial instrument. Always consult with a licensed financial advisor or regulatory authority in your jurisdiction before engaging in trading activities.
Okay. Hold this. Let's start on this. 10:20. Oh, it's a bill coming up. So I'm thinking like 20. 1, 2, 25. Dixie. Okay. Okay, this is me working on ThanksGrip. Alright, so go here. Okay. What's this target hit? And we got this, which is good. And that makes sense. Target hit daily. Tomorrow's the kind of like the last good day, I feel like, for the week. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Okay, this is the weekly open. Price is kind of getting held down. Oh, I feel like this is it. Like, this is the next liquidity pool. 106, 960. So, yeah, that was known yesterday. 106, 960. Is my target. Looks good on a daily. Go to H4. See what we got here. Sat on this. Kind of weaked a lot. Retracement. Yeah. Sticking to the same plan higher for now. Let's go to H1. Where's this at? Right here. 106, 960. We completely feel this. Let's take this out. This kind of held true. It's my target. All right, let's go to ZN. This target missed. It's always either dollar or bonds, it seems like, but then the rest of them be on point. Where's that? There you go. Target missed. Let's go to the daily. Let's delete this too. Well, that's actually weekly open. I'm thinking that's going to go up. Yeah, that might actually be the same target. What do we got going on here? Choppy and ugly. On the daily. Let's go to H4. We did sweep this. Previous week's high. We still haven't. It's inside week. Inside week, we could chop until the next monthly cycle, because next week is the holiday. Let's go back to H1. Same target, 109.13.5.13.5 is my target. Let's go to yen. Target hit. Target hit. Let's go to the daily. Why is this so big? Oh snap. This is kind of choppy too. No institutional order flow. Kind of choppy. No institutional order flow. I think next year I can look at less charts and do more time frames. Because I want to do this monthly, weekly, on a regular. We didn't hit this. I do like this level though. 0.0064300. Where's the other one at? You already hit that. Here. 0.0064300. .0064300 is my target. Let's go to H1. Target remains the same. Let's go to cab. Let's see what we did first. It's time you missed on cab. Cab didn't do nothing. Look like it's a perfect inside day. Daily. What we got going on here? Order flow still. Like we're not taking lows. We're not having a complete smart money reversal yet. Yeah, we haven't took any lows. Yeah, I still like the same target. I still like the same target. Looks like a retracement for higher prices. Let's go to H4. I mean, we kind of came back into this H4 volume and balance. Still need sell side down there, but 0.7860 looks good still. .0771860 is my target. Go to H1. I'm thinking higher prices. Look at how this came. It did that perfect from the H4. target is the same. Let's call it MNQ. MNQ has been so uneventful. We've literally been spinning, just spinning. There's trades in here, but this ain't order flow. This target missed though. I want it higher. Target miss, go to the daily. Look at this. I mean, retracement kinda. What's this? The weekly open, that's what that is. I still can see this as the draw. I'm gonna still keep this as the target. We need Friday's high, even if that's just to internal range liquidity to go lower. 2980 is my target. Still, I'm thinking higher before lower. We haven't had smart money reversal just yet. Okay, I'm sticking to the plan. We've just been chopping. Now I'm thinking, since last week was a large range week, this week will be choppy logic. Let's go to H1. $29.80 is my target. Let's go to MBS. Was this target missed on here? Let's go daily. Yeah, similar to NQ. I'm thinking higher for now. Let's go to H4. Price has kind of been choppy all week. Price has been choppy all week. No previous week was large range. I don't think we're gonna make it to previous weeks, huh? Keeping the same energy, 5, 9, 7, 4 and a quarter. Five, nine, seven, four, and a quarter. Target. MYM. It was bearish yesterday. Inside day to day, target missed. Target missed. Let's go to the daily. Still, now this looks like it can be all the way done, you know. This looks more bullish than any other ones, than any of the other ones. This looks more bullish than any other indice. What is going on? Yeah, but I just can't put an indice. I have to put the S on it. Okay. That's much more bullish than the other indices. Okay. It's still an accumulation, still choppy, but at least we left previous week's range. Still choppy, but at least we left the previous week's range. Let's go to H1. Yeah, I'm keeping the same target here too. So same plan as today, basically. 43,600. You know what I just thought about too? Cause I was looking for the buy, but then I was thinking the sale was gonna happen, but. If I would have stayed looking for the buy, I would have been better off being one-sided. Because I was bullish on indices. And I tried to take a sale. Getting caught up in the flow. 43,660 is the target. 43,660 is the target. Matter of fact, I'm actually writing on this. Look for buys. I need a new that's better. So now I can put it on there. There we go. Got one of those desktop dry erase boards, but it look like a marker. It's kind of cool. Let's go here. Let's target hit. Target hit. Yeah, let's go to the daily. Let's go here. 157.302. Still thinking higher. Because I'm bullish on dollar. Okay. Go to the H4. Our next level would be this order block. We could turn around here. 156.266. Is my target for Wednesday, or tomorrow's Thursday. I do like this. Well, I really like this level, but we'll stick to that one. I believe they had that news today too. Go here, Forex Factory. Yeah, that was. Yeah, so unemployment's tomorrow. Okay. 156.266. Sticking to the same target. Let's go to UC. And this target miss, and we're actually breaking through that level, so we can look for lower prices, which is weird. Target missed. Let's go to the daily. Kind of playing in this level though. But I still think lower. 1.39304. Still looks good to me. H4. Okay, we took this out. This is a low broken. It's monthly open. Still looks bearish. Still looks bearish. I'm waiting. Yeah, that's it. Look at that. Equal lows. 1.39304 is my target. Let's go to CJ. Where is this target at? Okay, that's target missed because I wanted the moon. You missed, and let's go to the date me. We swept that, but yeah, I still like 112, 110. I still like 112.110. Let's go to H4. I like how we're using that daily fair value gap as an inversion level. Value cap at a inversion level overall. Let's go to H1. One 12, 110 is my target. One 12, 110 is my target. All right, that's that on that. Ready for Thursday. Y'all have a good day. Peace.